Gonna finish off another series this episode with Disney's Herbie Rescue Rally. This is also the first DS game I'm covering on this channel. I received a better computer after finishing episode 38 and going on my break that could run emulators and OBS without dying, and I decided to test it out on a smaller game. I've accepted that I'm not going to be able to legit capture DS games anytime soon, but I have like 80 DS games just waiting to be recorded, so I decided to emulate ones I own so I can actually record a decent chunk of my collection. I'm going to be more willing to use emulators in certain circumstances in the future, but I'll get to those when it's relevant. But yeah, Herbie. I covered the GBA Herbie game about 100 games ago, and hated it. I thought it was okay at best until actually playing the Grand Prix modes and finding it would kick you out for placing badly in one race even if you were leading on points. And this game was made by the same developer, so we'll see if he managed to improve things in the 2 years since. This game also has a story mode like Fully Loaded, but this one is an original story not based on a film. I think. I've still only seen Fully Loaded. Instead of unflattering screen grabs of the film actors, we have clip art of super deformed people. It stars Louise, who is about to start her new job at a speedway. Her dad, clearly Dexter's dad with dyed hair and keeping a secret second family, and mum don't want her to leave as they want her to help out at their animal sanctuary. They keep trying to talk her out of it, but she just loves racing so much. Plus there's a Grand Prix at the speedway this summer. She sets off and meets Jackson at the speedway at the end of her shift, exhausted but loving the work. You can tell Jackson is supposed to be a cool dude, because he rarely takes his hands out of his pockets. He and his friends like to race after the speedway is closed for the night, and he invites Louise to watch, but she wants to race too. She doesn't have a car, so Jackson lets her try out Herbie, who he keeps in the back. He even says that Herbie used to be a big star, but that was a long time ago. Well, this game was the last Herbie anything, and it came out 16 years ago, so it was even longer ago now. Of course, because Herbie is alive, he has to like Louise for him to let her drive him. Good thing it seems that Herbie is like a dog, he just likes anyone he sees right away. So I get to take him for a test. Collecting 53 tokens will allow me to perform a Herbie moment that lets me skip a chunk of the track, or as I like to call it, cheat. This first track, Swift Valley Speedway 1, is a simple oval with a pair of bends going inwards on opposite ends of the track. You can drift around corners for a boost, but the drift itself is very sharp, so you have to be careful. There are items found by collecting question mark tokens, but at first I'm not quite used to the steering, so I keep ending up a little short and missing them. Filling the bar with 53 tokens will place a spot on the map for the Herbie moment. In this track's case, I drive into it and get carried off further along the track by a helicopter. As I said, cheat. You're supposed to spin these icons on the touchscreen to make it go faster, but I could never get my mouse cursor there in time and spin enough before it runs out, so I miss out on a lot of extra speed. You don't want to run into any oil slicks the rival racers drop, by the way. They'll turn you completely around and put you against a wall, and I lose my huge lead just turning back around. Good thing my rivals are idiots who all ram into each other and get each other stuck. Triangular icons will let you do a wheelie speed boost, but I only work out the correct button to use an item right at the end of my fourth and final lap. But I win, and look at these other racer names. Rick Vapors, Bro Peep. Louise is impressed by Herbie's performance, and so is Jackson. He thought he was just giving her the car equivalent of a cheap shitty Mad Catz controller so she could play too. Louise wants another go, but Jackson instead recommends the Velocity practice track, as it has harder corners for her to try out. Jackson suggests Louise give Herbie a cooler name, but his suggestions are shit. I imagine kids hearing of Flash Rescue Rally would be disappointed to learn they're stuck in a car. So, Velo Speedway 1. From the start, I can pick up a tyre and shoot it forward like a green shell. This was in Fully Loaded too. This track starts with a roundabout, then is mostly a square with a little turn halfway through over this bridge. The corners are harder, but only barely. The Herbie moment on this track has him grind the wall of the bridge on his arse. I almost come second when Jackson tries to ram me off the road at the last corner, but I save the tyre for him and take my first place. I unlock a new horn if I want to quit out of the game and switch it on in the options. Louise gets a few seconds of celebration before Jackson is moving her up to the High Hopes mountain range. Then he tells her it'll be too dangerous for her with all its sharp corners and rock slides. He says he has to think of her safety so she can't come, but Herbie takes her along anyway. So I think he and Herbie are working together trying to get her killed. High Hopes Mountain Range Track 1 is a square with a little turn inwards at the start going into a little tunnel. I finally grab myself a question mark token that grants me a random item. In this case it's one that turns Herbie into a bumper car for a little bit. The first two laps are a little straightforward, but then we get stuff happening on lap 3 when a rock slide starts. But I dodge it with my Herbie moment, which has him speed along the edge of the barrier next to the cliff while shooting rainbows. I have to deal with it on the final lap, but the bigger problem then is everyone not trying to overtake me, but grind themselves into me to slow me down. I still finish first though, I even unlock Jackson's car to play as. Jackson acts like he expected inviting her along and then telling her not to come would actually work. He says that he's the best driver here and said it was too dangerous. Well, clearly he's not, because he only came third. Pretending to care about her safety is going out the window now as he challenges her to another race way out in the desert on the Dust Devil Plains. Hey ladies, if an angry guy told you to follow him out into the desert for a one-on-one race right after an argument, would you follow him? Dust Devil Plains 1 is definitely a little more complex than the previous tracks. A lot of turns here. I knock Jackson's whining ass behind me with a tyre and keep him there. The first two laps go by pretty chill, but then on the second lap a massive tornado makes its way onto the track. I'm not really a fan of these in-race cutscenes, as when it cuts back to gameplay, you could have been in the middle of a turn or something, and the interruption can mess you up. Luckily, the tornado decided to just hang out off the road and just watch the race. Jackson manages to get back in front for the final lap, but I have the power of cheating on my side. For this track's Herbie moment, he drives along the wall, which somehow makes him faster, and gets back in front. And I stay there. Jackson only manages to shoot me after I've won. I unlock a new item for later races. Jackson concedes and says that he should be getting back because it's late. Louise realises that while getting roped into all these races, she forgot to feed the animals. Her parents don't seem to care, and want her to sign a petition to the city council, complaining about the Evile Corporation's chemical factory choking their animals to death. Louise says that she has her job at the Speedway, but they're not having it. Louise ignores them though and goes off with Herbie. She gets to the Speedway, but this old git is hogging the track for himself today. He's having trouble with his own living car, Chip. Chip, he claims, is just the best and fastest car around, and you could never understand him. Louise laughs her ass off at this, and the two have a race to settle it. And two others join in, when it has nothing to do with them. Speedway 2 has the debut of boost panels, though they're only in two spots. Jackson's car gets ahead early on and I can't catch up because Chip is powered by spite and keeps ramming into me to hold me back. The track itself has a permanent oil slick you can easily slip on since they put it in the middle of one of the sharper turns. The item I unlocked is a speed boost that can be further powered up by yelling into the DS microphone. But there is no DS microphone on my computer, so all it does is cover up my map. The Herbie moment has him drive through a wall of tyres to find a hidden road and skip ahead. But one of the AI racers knew about this and left an oil slick in the exact spot I'd regain control. Despite that, I still finish first. The inventor believes there must be something wrong with Chip and goes to fix him. Louise offers help, but he's a prick and brushes her off. He takes an interest in Herbie though, and offers a second race at the Velocity track. Velocity 2 is an expansion of the first track. Once you reach that roundabout, the previous route is blocked off and you have a few extra roads to turn through before you reach the bridge that now has a ramp on it. As you can see on the map, there are some greyed out roads that you can drive on as alternate routes. I believe they are slightly quicker, but not enough to make a difference. The Herbie moment is at the roundabout. Herbie will drive around the fountain to build up speed and then launch himself further down the track. At the end of the lap is his spinning hat item that lets Kirby turn around and reverse through the track faster than his usual speed. It gets a bit worrying when an oil slick gets me near the end and I'm overtaken. And in the end, I end up coming third, with Jackson and the inventor beating me. But the game acts as if I won anyway, and the inventor continues to show his interest in Herbie. Louise accuses him of trying to copy Herbie, even though Herbie lost. He continues adjusting Chip and decides to extend their competition into the mountains. Instead of racing others, I'm alone against the clock. I have to travel as far as I can before time runs out, every clock I pick up adding a second to my timer. The main hazards in this track are two sharp turns. The first one is at the start after a long section going uphill, and the second is around two-thirds of the way through as you end up downhill again. Like the first mountain track, a rock slide starts on the second lap, this one about three-quarters of the way through. The Herbie moment is around the top of the first hill. The theme for this one is being a total dick, as Herbie drives through the tables of this nice cafe, and then jumps off a cliff to end up at the bottom of the hill. There are markers near the end of the third lap to determine my ranking based on how long I've been going, with first place being at the end of the third lap and finishing the race. I also unlock Chip as a playable character. The inventor brags that he now knows all of Herbie's secrets, and that he and Chip will beat everyone at the Cross State Grand Prix. Louise says that Herbie still has more tricks, and the inventor suggests one more race. And even after stating that he's looking to copy Herbie's abilities, she falls for it and suggests the Dust Devil Plains. Jackson suggests Louise shouldn't drive while she's angry. But fuck Jackson, he's only the first boss, it's not his place to give the main character orders. Dust Devil Plains 2's most notable feature is that it's shaped like Donkey Kong's head if you rotate it clockwise a little. Or something more suggestive, I'll let you decide. This time some of the roads are boarded off and I'll have to drive over dirt roads or through caves. At the start of the final lap, a tornado appears a little bit further on, much trickier to avoid than the previous tornado. The Herbie moment is in the cave, he'll jump into a minecart and speed along the track. Is a minecart faster than a car? A minecart with the whole car inside weighing it down? I unlock another new item for winning this one. The inventor can't believe he lost, but says he can now make his final adjustments to finish the perfect racing machine. But instead, Chip fucking dies, and Louise laughs at the poor car's end. Louise goes home and God, this fucking animal sanctuary. First it's more important than my job, then the animals are all hacking their lungs out, and now they're being closed down. The owner of E-Vile, Edward Vile, got annoyed at the petition and has decided to just buy out the land and dump sewage on it. Well, yes, that is a monstrous thing to do and an overreaction. I've got to respect that level of spite. Let's be honest, we've all had those moments where someone's been too loud on the bus or pushed into a queue somewhere and thought, if I could, I would pump shit all over your house and make you homeless. Don't deny it. The land turns out to be worth $1 million. The dad points out a nearby TV that happens to be talking about it on the news, reported on by a man with the buttest butt chin you've ever seen. It turns out Edward Vile is the inventor I've been racing. Turns out he's not rich enough to afford it yet, but he plans to buy it with the winnings from the Cross State Grand Prix, assuming he's gonna win. The next day, Jackson apologises for the news, but look at that smug expression he has, he's not sorry for anything. Louise panics about helping Vile build the car that will let him win, and Jackson reminds Louise that the qualifying round for the Grand Prix is today. Louise decides not to take part until Jackson lets her know that the winner gets a free entry into the Grand Prix, of which the prize money is $1 million. They go to the qualifiers, the first of which is in Velo City. We meet our main car rival for the next four races when a huge red monster truck with eyes pulls up. Velo City 3 lets me grab the new item right away, it's a homing tyre, like the Mario Kart red shell. The track starts off similar to the second track until you get past the roundabout and find a wall removed to reveal a ramp behind it leading to one last sharp turn before the rest of it ends up pretty close to the first Velo City track. The Herbie moment is in front of the ramp and sees Herbie launch off it and drive on top of this roof. He could get even further if he just jumped off the other side instead of staying up there for a bit wasting time with more flips. This time I am never in any danger and easily finish first. The second round is in the Dust Devil Plains. Here we meet the driver of the monster truck, Big Bob, with the truck being named Rusty. He's a champion from another state and he's quite impolite and tries to intimidate Louise. Dust Devil Plains 3 has more turns than any track before it, and a lot more driving over dirt and through caves. I end up with a huge lead when Big Bob and another driver ram into each other and spend ages refusing to budge. But this game does have some almost Mario Kart 64-ian rubber banding, and they all manage to catch up and overtake by the end of the second lap. At least I discovered this slight shortcut in the area with the houses. And just to be a massive dick, the tornado this time is in front of the finish line. The Herbie moment this time has him ramping over a few rocks further into the track. I just barely managed to finish first, and so much for my new rival, third place in the previous race and dead last this time. And despite that, Jackson still sees them as a threat. Back at the speedway, he's still trying to scare Louise, but it's just not working. Are you allowed to outright threaten a fellow racer before a race? He won't be able to do anything though, as he next races a boost race. I have 2 minutes and 19 seconds to use boost panels on this track to get as far as I can. Speedway 3 is a lot simpler than the other track 3s, with its only notable feature being a big turn that goes down and under halfway through. Speaking of, that turn is a setting for this track's Herbie moment, where he'll drive on the wall and the ceiling of this tunnel, then zoom around the corner. This was pretty easy, and I finish all 4 laps with 5 seconds remaining, unlocking another Herbie horn sound. Jackson says he was worried about Louise for a second, and she seems happy to hear it, and disappointed when it's not in the way she was thinking. So, if you were not finding any hook with this game but you're into shipping, you've got this I suppose. Time for one last qualifying race, one-on-one against Big Bob, despite him doing terribly in all the other races. This one being in the third High Hope Mountains track. Mountains 3 gets to a great start when I ram myself into one of the beams in the first tunnel. I almost catch up to him later on, but he slams the brakes on so I hit him and stop dead in my tracks while he widens the gap again. I overtake on the second lap with the Herbie moment, that lets me get on skis and slide across the back of the streets and off a ledge. On the third lap we get the rock slide yet again. The track itself feels more simple than the second did and is unremarkable. I finish first and unlock Rusty as a playable character. Louise has won her spot in the Grand Prix and Bob has a whine about how it should have been him. And I mean whine, as he starts crying. Louise tries to comfort him by saying he can try again next year, but that doesn't work. She tells him she needs the money to save her animal sanctuary, and that calms him down. Instead, he tells Louise that she'd better win and save all those animals or he'll kick the shit out of her, I assume. We cut to the start of the Grand Prix. As usual, I have 4 more racers, one on each track type. Louise is nervous, while Jackson tells her how proud of her she is and that he has something to tell her. Don't get too invested as this big beast pulls up and interrupts. It's Edward Vile with his Herbie clone, Herman. Jackson makes fun of his name and Vile responds with, "I'm surprised Louise finds you attractive at all." How does he know anything about how these two think of each other? The first race starts on the fourth mountain track. Now this one is a lot more complex, turns everywhere and a lot of dash pads. It mixes in bits from all the previous mountain tracks, like the street from the third track and the uphill turns from the second. It's a lot longer too, so I only have to drive 3 laps instead of 4. I miss all my chances at the Herbie moment though. I finish first while Vile's car came last. And once again, despite him coming last, Jackson goes on and on about how fast Herman is and how well he handles. He's doing such a good job chilling him that Vile offers him the chance to switch teams. Take him. I thought he was being sarcastic, but when Jackson turns him down, it turns out he was genuinely trying to recruit Jackson. The second race is on the 4th Dust Devil Plains track. Once again, this track mixes and matches parts from the previous versions. It's a bit harder to tell though, since so much of the desert looks the same. There's the two bits with the houses along the road from the second and third tracks, but that's about it. This time a tornado appears halfway through the track. The Herbie moment has Herbie jump onto a ramp higher up on the side of the mountain and jump between the two mountains in this valley. I stay in first through the majority of the race, but then get hit by a tyre and overtaken right in front of the finish, landing in second. Still beat Herman though, and the game still acts as if I won anyway. Vile once again brags about how well he'll do any second now as he's just had his team upgrade Herman. He outright states that he definitely believes that throwing more money at the problem will make him win the race. Next we have the 4th Fellow City track. The first half is taken directly from the third track, then there's a tunnel and the rest of the lap is taken from Velo City 2. This track's Herbie moment is more driving along the walls of a tunnel. I pretty much stay in first place for the entirety of the third lap and win once again, with Vile in last place again, unlocking another horn. Louise is now in the final. Vile can be seen buying an even more powerful and expensive engine than Herman. Somehow, despite his terrible placing, the final race is me and him head to head. They go through some more repetitive arguing and the final race starts. Speedway 4 takes its first half from the third track, but then the rest of it is new stuff. A long section straight forward and some sharp turns near the end. The Herbie moment has him bounce over and out of the track and launch himself back in further on off a ramp. Herman is never any threat to me, and I finish first once again, unlocking Herman. Everyone congratulates Louise on her victory. She's won $1 million and even shown her boring parents how exciting the speedway is. Vile, meanwhile, has spent his entire fortune on upgrading Herman, and has to sell off the chemical factory causing all the problems in the first place. Since Louise doesn't need to buy the sanctuary anymore, she buys the chemical factory so the sanctuary can expand onto its land. Jackson tries to do the cool, "My job here is done, goodbye forever." Louise praises his mechanic skills and Herbie encourages her to just hurry up and get it over with, so she gives him a kiss, in case you were worried that would be left unresolved. Well, that's story done, now for the Grand Prix mode. They have me racing through all the tracks of the same kind, so I don't need to go into detail on this one. At least the devs learned from last time and don't kick you out regardless of points if you place too low once. First is the Speedway Cup. I come first in all 4 races and unlock the Velo City Cup. I come first in all 4 races and unlock the Mountain Cup. I can at least show off Mountain 4's Herbie moment, more driving along the walls of a tunnel. First in all 4 races and I unlock the Desert Cup. First in the first 3 races and second in the last to still win on points. This unlocks the Super Grand Prix. It's a cup of all 4 track 4s against all 3 rival races at once. Once again I finish first in all but 1 race to win on points. That would be it, but I notice one of my horns is still locked, so I assume I needed to do better in one of the story races I lose. And it turns out I needed to win Velo City 2. And that's all there is to do in this game. I assume the other playable cars are multiplayer only. Herbie Rescue Rally is okay at best. It's definitely better than Fully Loaded. It has more to do and lacks my biggest issue with that game. It plays fine, but only 4 track types gets old and the music isn't the most memorable out there. Although that main menu theme will haunt me for a while with how it plays everywhere else in the game. Overall, it had just squeezed right into the bottom end of the okay section of my ranking. Probably placed near fellow just okay racing games Dukes of Hazzard and Sonic Drift. This is also my 6th completed series on this channel, though I don't have too much to say. My feelings are like an exaggerated version of my thoughts when I finished the Dark Seal series. I had the first game I hated, followed by an unmemorable okay game. Maybe if I was into Herbie I'd have more to say or get more out of it, but I'm not, so I don't.